Hello dear followers, welcome to this video. Let's see how to use the newest Corel VideoStudio Pro X10 in the quickest and easiest way. Leave us comments in the video description to improve our future videos dedicated to VideoStudio Pro. Corel VideoStudio is great video editing software used to create and export your own customized videos and slideshow made of pictures, videos, text, and amazing effects. Let's see in a short time all the basic features you need to know to start using it. When you open VideoStudio and you are connected to the internet, you will be directed to the welcome page. This is very helpful for beginners, offering several useful tutorials, effects, templates, and more. Also, VideoStudio has three workspaces you can see on top: Capture, Edit, and Share. Capture is used to record media, such as videos, your computer screen, or audio from your microphone. Edit is used to create and build your own video starting from your media and adding adjustments, text, and effects. Share is used to render and export your video created through the Edit workspace. In this beginner tutorial, we will see the Edit and Share workspaces. The Edit workspace is divided in two main parts. Above, you have several panels, such as the Video Preview and other panels that have the main features of VideoStudio. At the bottom, you have the project timeline where you will work and edit your project, creating your own video. To start working, you have to import your media first, such as videos, pictures, and sound files. If you click on Media, you can browse for several sample files available that you can import by clicking and dragging them on the project timeline. To add your own media files instead, you have to import these on the Media panel first. You can drag and drop your files from your computer folder to the panel first, or click on Import Media Files to browse for them. Once they are on the Media panel, just drag and drop them on the project timeline. The files imported inside the timeline are called clips and are represented through small rectangles showing a quick preview of the clip content and its file name. You can zoom in and out of the timeline by holding Ctrl down and using your mouse wheel. Clips are contained inside rows called tracks, depending on their kind. Pictures and videos are contained inside video and overlay tracks. Text inside title tracks, and speech recordings and sound files inside voice and music tracks. This is what you see when using the timeline view. We are going to see just this one since it allows you to edit your videos more professionally. Clips also show a different background color. Pictures and video frames are in a dark green color, text and titles in green color, and sound files and speech in a violet or in a blue color, depending on the kind of track that contains them. To check your project in progress, you have to use the video preview in the top left corner. This can work in project or in clip mode. When the preview is in the project mode, it shows the overall content inside the project timeline, including the way the clips are placed. In particular, this shows what the project looks like right where the playhead is placed. So you can select a particular frame by clicking once on the project timeline, or click and drag it on the timeline to check the project forward or backward frame by frame. Keep in mind that this won't play back any audio. To listen to audio, you have to play back the overall project by using the player below the preview. If you click on a clip, this will be selected and highlighted in orange, and the preview will go in clip mode. This is used to play back the clip on its own and also edit the way it must be shown, in case it is a picture or a video. You can move it by clicking and dragging it, and you can scale it by using the yellow nodes. Use the corner nodes to save the original aspect ratio. Use the small green nodes to skew and distort the clip. Let's see how to edit clips. To move a clip in time, just click and drag it on the left or right. You can also move it to another track. Pay attention when you move visual clips. These can be placed inside the video track or an overlay track, which are quite different. All clips that are contained inside video tracks are always placed one after another, whereas the clips inside overlay tracks can be placed at any time, allowing time gaps. Also, clips inside overlay tracks are always placed above the ones inside the video track, so all the main videos composing your project should stay inside the video track and all the extras such as text, titles, and pictures inside the overlay track. Video clips can be composed by video frames and also audio sound. In this case, a small orange speaker icon appears, indicating that there is audio. If you move this clip, you will move both frames and audio together. But if you want to make these independent, right-click on the video clip and go to Split Audio. The clip audio will be dropped on the voice track, becoming independent. You can stretch and shorten clips by clicking and dragging their edges. When you stretch videos and sound clips, you may not be able to go over their duration, whereas if you shorten them, you will cut part of their content. If you click and drag the clip edges while holding Shift down, you stretch or shorten the clip by changing its playback speed without affecting its content. So, if you shorten it, this will be played faster. If you stretch it, this will be played slower. To copy and paste a clip, right-click on it and go to Copy, and then place the copy where you like. Go to Delete to remove the clip instead. If you make a mistake, use Control and Z, or the big undo arrow above to undo. To split a clip in more pieces, place the playhead where you like, and then use the S key from your keyboard. On the far left, you have several icons, one per each kind of track. You can click on it to disable a track in order to hide all its contents from the preview. Click again to enable the track. You can insert new overlay, title, and music tracks by right-clicking on a track and going to Insert Track. Now, let's get a general overview on the main amazing features contained inside VideoStudio. Below the Media button, the Title button opens a panel showing several title templates ready to use. Choose one and drag and drop it on your project. This creates a new title clip under a green color with a T icon on the left, contained inside a title track or an overlay track. If you prefer to create a title from scratch, select the project mode on the preview with the title panel open and double-click inside to start typing. Click elsewhere to apply. At this point, a new title clip is created on the timeline. To edit the title clips, just select them on the timeline and the preview will open in clip mode. You can add other pieces of text by double-clicking on the preview and edit their appearance by selecting them and clicking and dragging to move, using the yellow nodes to scale. Use the violet ones to rotate the piece of text selected. Also, each piece of text selected can be edited through the options panel on the right, such as their font family, style, size, color, and paragraph. You can also apply amazing effects and transitions to your clips. The filters are special effects used to enhance the appearance or the sound of your clips. If you click on Filter, you will open a panel showing several ready visual effects. Choose one and drag and drop it on a clip. This clip will show an FX icon indicating that a filter is applied to it. When you select a clip, go to Options and then to the Attributes section to check and manage all the effects applied. By default, only the latest filter is applied, since the Replace Last Filter option is enabled. If you disable it, you can apply multiple effects on the same clip, all listed under the Attributes section. Click on one effect to select it. Click on the eye icon to enable or disable the effect, and use the up and the down arrows on the right to change the effect order. Use the cross button to remove the effect. Go to Customize Filter to change the properties of the effect selected. Under the Attributes section of Sound Clips and Videos with Sound, you can also use Audio Filter to add audio effects. Check it out! There are also the transitions. These are special effects used to make clips appear and disappear in a cool way. Click on Transition to open the full list of transitions available inside VideoStudio, and drag and drop it to the beginning or the ending side of a visual clip. This will show the transition icon and its duration in time. Transitions can also be added in between two visible clips in order to go from the first clip to the second one with the chosen effect. To edit the transition, you have to enable the transition button first and then select the transition on the timeline. At this point, you can change its duration by dragging its edges and its effect properties by going to the Options panel. To change the kind of transition, just drag and drop it on another. To delete a transition, right-click on it and go to Delete. It is also important to save your project in order not to lose your work. Just go to File and then to Save As. These .vsp file formats save the complete status of your project, such as timeline content, effect options, and transitions added. If you want to export your project content and render it to a video, you have to open the Share workspace. Here, you can choose how to export it. Choose Computer to save the final video inside your computer. Device to export the video to a smartphone or a console. Web to render and upload your video directly to YouTube or a social website. Disk to burn your video to a DVD or a Blu-ray. For example, if you choose Computer, set the video file format on top, the resolution and frame rate under Profile and Properties, and set up the file name and location at the bottom. When you are ready, start rendering by going to Start. By default, you will render the whole timeline content, but if you want to render just a part of it, you can regulate the orange markers below the video preview and select the exact part to export. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides.